Assalamu alaikum. Today Thursday, March 19, 2020. Taliban promises safe passage for coronavirus health workers. Group urges health agencies to send support to areas under their control in Afghanistan, which has reported 22 cases. The Taliban in Afghanistan has promised safe passage to international healthcare organization and humanitarian workers who are fighting against the coronavirus. In a statement on Wednesday, the group urges health agencies to provide medicine, send aid and the necessary equipment to the areas under their control. Our brotherly businessmen, in line with their Islamic and humanitarian responsibility, must also support their fellow people in this time of crisis, the statement said. The Taliban claims the virus is a godsend in response to disobedience and sin of mankind. Afghanistan has 22 confirmed cases of COVID-19. Health concerns are mounting in the country every day. Thousands of Afghans cross the border with Iran, the regional epicenters of the crisis. In 2019, the Taliban banned the International Committee of the Red Cross, ICRC, and the World Health Organization, WHO, alleging the two organizations were conducting suspicious activities. The group later revoked it. Ban. On Tuesday, European Union Special Envoy for Afghanistan, Ronald Kobia, called for a full ceasefire in view of the growing coronavirus threat. Everyone has the right to be helped against coronavirus. To be better helped, first measures should be full ceasefire, stop taxing humanitarian aid, ensure full access and safety, coordinate and cooperate with government, Kobia said, an apparent message to the Taliban. Welcoming the statement, Waheed Umar, a senior AD to President Ashraf Ghani, also called on the Taliban to stop attack and allow health workers to reach vulnerable areas. There are reports of Taliban causing problems to health service in some areas of Afghanistan. Umar tweeted on Wednesday, it should be stopped immediately. Spanish death toll climbs to 767. Spain's death toll climbs by over 200 in a day. Russia announced first death due to the virus. Spain said the death toll from the coronavirus epidemic soared by 209 to 767 fatalities overnight, as Russia announced that a 79-year-old woman with the virus was recorded as the country's first confirmed death resulting from the pandemic. Italy, the country most affected by the coronavirus outside China, reported further 475 deaths from COVID-19 on Wednesday. As the world steps up efforts against pandemic by closing schools, shutting down cities and imposing strict border controls, the UK was the latest to announce it would close schools. The US and Canada meanwhile have closed their border to all but essential traffic. Nearly 2,20,000 people have now been confirmed with the coronavirus globally, and while at least 84,000 people have recovered from COVID-19, more than 8,800 have died, according to data from Johns Hopkins University in the US. Today, Thursday, 19 March, India bars international commercial passengers' flight from landing for 1 week. India's government said it will ban all scheduled international commercial passengers' flight from landing in the country from March 22 for 1 week to contain the spread of coronavirus. India has already suspended visas for the vast majority of foreigners seeking to enter the country. Pakistan seals Wagah border for 14 days. Pakistan on Thursday sealed Wagha border with India as a preventive measure to halt the spread of coronavirus in the country. According to a notification by the Interior Ministry, the border will be closed for 2 weeks. Border closure is in the interest of both Pakistan and India, the notification added. The move comes after the number of the confirmed coronavirus cases hit 329 in Pakistan. On Wednesday, the country reported its first death from coronavirus, both from Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. The first victim was a 50-year-old from Mardan who had recently returned from Umrah. Thanks for watching TV Khabar News Studio. Have a nice day. Take care.